Good wishes, dear students. We have learnt in detail the different general properties of P block element. Now we are moving into the study of learning the group elements individually along with their preparation, physical, chemical properties and usage. So we will start with the group number 13, group 13 elements. Now group 13 is made up of boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium, leaving out the radioactive metal. Now under this group, two types of elements you will learn in detail. One is a boron, the other one is of aluminium. We'll go with the boron. Now boron element we derive from the ore borax and kernite. Both have the same molecular formula. The only point of difference is the number of water molecule present within them. Now borax formula Na2B4O5 OH 4 times and 8 times the water molecule. But when you look for kernite, the same formula Na2B4O5 OH 4 times and 2 times the water molecule. Now the atomic number of boron, which all of you know very well, is a 5, and electronic configuration Helium 2s2 2p1. Now boron most of the time exists in the form of a borates. Now what's the meaning of borates? It's a combination of boric acid along with the basic radical, about which we will see later. Right now I'm not moving into. So all you have to remember is boron element is obtained from the ore borax and kernite, their atomic number along with the electronic configuration. Now directly we are being a metal element that we have taken, directly we are moving on to the chemical properties. Now as a student regarding inorganic chemistry, the only aversion most of us have is aversion towards the chemical properties and the physical properties, because there will be plenty to learn. But I will give you the shortest and easiest trick for you all to remember. For any chemical property, when you begin to learn, kindly make the chart of it in this manner. Now for example, I am going to teach you the chemical properties of boron. Now to learn the chemical properties easily, all you have to remember is point number 1, how to balance the equation, about which I have taught you and most of you know. Point number 2, you need to know what are the reactants that you are taking with the correct molecular formula, and what are the products again with the correct molecular formula. If you know the molecular formula of the reactants and the molecular formula of the products, balancing the equation is very easy. You needn't by heart, some small tips will help you out. Now the tips I'm providing you here. Now all these reactions I'm going to show you. Now what I have done, now boron, when I for reaction number 1, boron when I treat with a metal, I get a metal boride. Boron, when I treat with a hydride, I get a diborane. Now what's the formula for a diborane? B2H6. Now boron, when you treat with a halogen, I get a boron trihalide. What's the formula for a halide? Trihalide, BX3. X stands for halogen, we all know that. Boron, when I treat with a nitride, I get a boron nitride. What's the formula for a boron nitride? Just BN. Boron, you treat with the oxygen, I get a boron oxide. Formula is B2O3. Boron, you treat with the acid, I get a boric acid. The formula H3BO3. Boron, you treat with an alkali, I get a sodium borate. You know sodium is the most alkaline in nature. So when I'll show you the reaction, when I treat with alkali, I get a sodium borate. The formula is Na2BO3. So for any chemical property, if you are able to make a small chart of it, this will help you when you study for an exam point of view. You needn't go through the reactions individually. You know what are the reactants you are taking, with what are you treating it, finally what's your product. The correct formula for a reactants and the products, balancing the equation is of very easy. Let's move to the topic. As I told you, point number 1, boron, I'm treating with a metal, I get a metal boride. So formation of a metal boride. Here we have taken it to be treating it with a chromium. So N stands for the number of molecules. So boron, when I treat with a chromium, I mean, one more thing I forgot to tell you. Boron is the smallest element, I mean atom, smallest element, and it require very hard to break it. High temperature should be provided. So almost in every reactions you will see high temperature is being provided. So boron, when you treat with a metal, I get a metal boride. N stands for the number of molecule that you are taking. Now, reduction of boron trihalides. Now, boron trihalide, when you treat it with a tungsten, the temperature condition is given. Now, you know, reduction meaning addition of hydrogen. What do I get here? I get a metal boride along with the chlorine, and HCl goes out here. Now formation of a hydride. Now I mean no boron trifluoride, you treat with a hydride. How will you identify the hydride formula? H hydrogen presence will be there. When you treat it, I get a diborane along with the sodium fluoride. Because fluorine is present, combines with the sodium, sodium fluoride goes out here. Now formation of boron trihalide. Now as I told you, treat it with a halogen. Boron, you treat with a halogen, I get a boron trihalide. Of course, balancing the equation, I have done it in the blue color ink. The fourth one, formation of a boron nitride. Boron, you treat with a nitrogen, I get a boron nitride. I don't think anything difficult for you all to remember in this point. Coming back to here, formation of an oxide. Now boron, you treat with an oxygen, the temperature condition is given to you, I get a boron oxide of the formula B2O3. Now this is a very important one. You can see the symbol here. Reaction with acids and alkali. Boron, when you treat it with an oxidizing agent, please remember the importance of the word here. I will explain to you. Oxidizing acids, that can be H2SO4 or HNO3, sulfuric acid or a nitric acid. Why get a boric acid? What's the formula for a boric acid? H3PO3. Boron, I'm treating it with a sulfuric acid, I get a boric acid plus sulfur dioxide. All you have to remember is boron you treat with a sulfuric acid, sulfur dioxide goes out. The remaining molecules get together to give me a boric acid of the formula H3BO3. Now when you treat boron with a nitric acid, what goes out here? Nitrogen dioxide goes out. The remaining get together to give me boric acid. So sulfuric acid also gives you boric acid. Nitric acid also gives you boric acid. Now these are reactions with the acid. Now when they react with an alkaline solution or alkali, what happens? Sodium. Now this is the most highly reactive. I get a sodium borate. What's the formula for a sodium borate? Na2BO3. Now being the small reactions, I went quickly. But when we proceed with the difficult reactions, I will teach you different manner of studying. Now once again, I'm telling you, when you study the chemical property for every concept or for every chapter, try to make a chart of it. So all you have to remember is what reactant you are taking, what are you treating, what product you are getting. So you need to know the molecular formula. Balancing the equations will be easier one. Now one more thing I need to tell you. What's the meaning of oxidizing acids? Now if I take H2SO4 is the acid, how will they get split into H plus HSO4 minus? Now this is my cation. H plus is a cation and H minus is an anion. Now in this case, when you call them as an oxidizing acids, anion's oxidizing potential is greater than the H plus ions or a proton that is present here. So once again, I'm telling, oxidizing acids, when you say the anion's oxidizing potential is greater than the H plus ions or a proton. Thank you. I gave you my heart.